But a lack of gonadotrophin is only one of the reasons for infertility. A marriage may remain childless because of a husband's low sperm count, or because a wife's fallopian tubes are blocked. This is an operation to remove eggs from a subfertile woman as part of a series of experiments to fertilize the human egg outside the body. The egg may then be replaced in the womb for what's hoped will be a normal pregnancy. But if this fertilization outside the body takes place, could a test tube baby become a fact? Is there anything to prevent science permitting the embryo to grow for a full 9 months in a laboratory? Scientists and gynecologists insist that this is not likely in the foreseeable future. But the fact remains that, given the raw material, British scientists are today capable of initiating the first stage in the growth of a human being.
Doctor, what exactly are you doing?
Well, I'm just examining fluid which we have removed from the ovaries of a patient to find some egg cells.
And what are you going to do with the egg cells?
Well, the object of this is, if these eggs are suitable and have come to the right degree of development, to fertilize them in a chamber like this with a husband's spermatozoa.
And what's the objective of this?
Well, the object is eventually, in this particular couple, is to be able to allow them to have a child, because they can't at the moment, because the woman's tubes are incapable of allowing sperms to get to the eggs.
So that conception, if you like, takes place outside the body of the woman?
Yes, in this particular type of case.
And what are you going to do with the fertilized egg once you have fertilized it?
Well, first of all, we have to see whether it will develop properly. Then, if this is so, we then have to try to get it to grow to a stage in which it could be replaced into the woman's own womb. The best incubator, and if I may say so, the cheapest incubator, is a woman. So if we can merely do for a patient what she can't do herself in the very, very earliest stages of development, in other words, where she's got good ovaries, she's got a good womb, and she's got a perfectly fertile husband, but she's got defective tubes. If we can do for her what normally takes place in the tubes, and then put into her womb an embryo in the same stage that it would be had she done it herself, this, as far as I'm concerned, is a reasonable project.